Hi everyone, thank you for attending this presentation. My name is Pablo Cinemanas and this is a collaborative work of researchers from the Music Technology Group from Barcelona and the Audio Processing Group from Universidad de la República, Uruguay. We are presenting the Case Models, a Python library for computational environmental sound analysis using deep learning models. Deep learning techniques have become omnipresent because they have brought new state-of-the-art results in several research fields and have proved successful in realistic problems. The research community around the DKS workshop is also part of the phenomenon, since most recent works use deep learning models. For instance, you can see that 90% of the papers published at the last DKS proceedings use deep learning models. Deep learning has brought excellent results, but also other issues that need special attention. These models are much more complex than traditional classifiers and are data hungry. Also, we need more powerful hardware for the training process, and these models are more opaque than traditional classifiers. Besides, it has become increasingly difficult to be able to reproduce the findings or to compare a new method to early ones only based on the description present in the publication. For the optimal reuse of scientific research, several authors are advocating not only for open access publications and data, but also for the release of software and models that can be used across a variety of domains. In this sense, we developed the Case Models, a library for rapid prototyping of environmental sound analysis systems. The library provides a set of basic components that are generally part of these systems. In this way, the Case Models include functions to do the feature extraction, so you can define your network input easily. It also includes classes to manage publicly available data sets. It has functions to load the data to feed the models, and this library includes classes to manage the deep learning models. This also provides an abstraction layer to make the library independent of the backend used to implement the machine learning model. It currently includes Keras implementation of several models, which are ready to use with minimal effort. Right now, we are working on including TensorFlow 2 and PyTorch as other backend. We follow the next design principles. The library is easy to learn and use. It is lightweight and has a flat package layout. It defines concise interfaces and is easy to extend. It is backend independent, so you can use different machine learning libraries. The code is released under the MIT license and all the development is conducted on GitHub. This makes the project accessible for the community to use, test, contribute, and bring support. To show the potential of this library, we include several applications. Firstly, we provide some Python scripts that perform each step in the pipeline of a decay system. Secondly, we include several Jupyter notebooks that replicate some of the experiments reported in the literature and baseline from the decay challenges. Finally, a web interface for sound classification is also included as a proof of concept of the potential to build high-level application for environmental audio analysis. Besides, it provides visualization tools to explore the dataset and to inspect the errors made by the model. It is also possible to listen to the audio files of the dataset and to test the model on an audio file provided by the user. Well, now let me show you one of these notebooks that we publish in the library. I'm to replicate the result of this paper of Salomon and Bejo. First, we import the classes from the library. Then we define the parameters. We define the feature parameters, the train parameters, and the model parameters. And then we define the data set that we want to use. In this case, it's Urban Sound 8K. And we can download the data set and change the sampling rate. We then define the feature extractor that we want to use. In this case, it's the model spectrum, and then we can extract the features for this data set. Then we define the data generators that we want to use. We define a data generator for the training. and also an scalar for the data. And then we define a data generator for the validation set. And now we can define the model and we can see the architecture of the model. And then we train this model for, in this case, just one epoch, just to show you. Okay, and now we can evaluate the model in the test set. Okay, so if we can see the results as Seda will show you. Now let me show you the web application that we develop. In first place, we select the feature that we want to use, in this case, the Mel spectrogram. Then we select the data set, and now we can extract the features. Once the features are extracted, we can select our model, the model that we want to use, and create it. Okay, and also we can see the architecture of the network. Okay, now we can train this model. We select the number of epochs and other parameters. Let's put two epochs. Okay, and train. Okay, now in the plot, we can see the training process. So we can see the accuracy in the validation set and the loss also. And also we can visualize the data, the embedding space, for instance, or the output or whatever you want. And you can listen to the audio files. You can see more or less points in this space. And navigate through the data. We can also can evaluate the model, so we can see the class-wise metrics for this problem. To conclude, let's summarize the key points of the case models. This is an open source Python library, so we expect that the researchers from the case community use the library and provide us feedback. Also, we expect your contribution to improve the library. The case models has a flat and light design, so this makes the library really easy to use and extend. It is also easy to integrate with other tools, so therefore this library helps to develop high-level application in a straightforward manner. We think that the case models improves research reproducibility in this field, so this can simplify method comparison. Also, we expect this will be a helpful tool for researchers new to the field. Thank you very much. We look forward to get your feedback and contributions.